Hello everyone, my name is Tanya, and today I want to show you a brief guide on Style3D, by the end of which you'll be able to create an animation similar to this one. To begin, open the stylist3d.com website to register and download Style3 to your PC. I've left a link for an extended trial period of 4 months in the description of this video. Stylist3D is a platform for 3D fashion designers where you can showcase your portfolio. So, I launched Style3D and created a new avatar. I enjoy customizing the appearance of standard avatars and want to demonstrate how you can do it. In the Edit Avatar tab, you'll find numerous settings where you can completely alter the appearance and figure of the avatar simply by adjusting sliders. You can also choose a hairstyle and other accessories, as well as adjust emotions, select a suitable pose, or choose an animation for the avatar. You can also choose all these additions to your avatar from the resource library, rather than the Edit Avatar section. Now, add ready-made clothing to my avatar, which I previously downloaded from the resource library. I'm doing this to quickly showcase the capabilities of Style3D, giving you a general idea of this program. In my future tutorial videos, I'll explain how to create clothing from scratch. Here, we can see that the bra cups are visible. I'll simply change the skin of the avatar to make it completely nude. And now, I want to pick out some shoes and accessories. To do this, I open the resource library. To download new resources, click on the cloud button. Here, you can choose and download clothes, accessories, poses, animations, hair, and shoes for your avatar, all for free. Before attaching accessories, I'll decide on the animation for my character. During testing, I noticed that the heel clips into the leg. I'll simply choose different shoes and rerun the test animation. Once I'm satisfied with the result, I'll delete the test animation recording. Now I'll show you how to attach accessories. There are two methods. Just follow the video to understand how it's done. If you don't attach an accessory, it simply won't move with the avatar during animation. You can attach any item you create in this way, converting it to trim beforehand. Take a look at this test animation, where the beads follow the avatar. Of course, they won't simulate as real ones, but it still looks quite realistic. And now, I'll add glasses. I use the snap to button to quickly attach the glasses to the head. Don't be alarmed, the glasses took a strange position. I'll just adjust them, and then we'll see the result in the test animation. In a similar manner, I'm adding the remaining accessories. I can use either snap to or convert the object into an accessory. I've decided to change the shoes again and remove the beads to replace them with a more suitable decoration. For earrings, it's convenient to use the automatic symmetry function to add the second earring on the other ear. Transparent materials and fabrics may not display correctly in the 3D window of the program. Previously, we could only see accurate representation in offline rendering. However, in the new version of Style3D 6.1, you can now see this with real-time rendering. Let's fast forward a bit to show how it works. Just enable translucent or ray tracing rendering. Let's get back to modeling. I temporarily turned off real-time rendering to avoid overloading the computer, and I'll enable it again when recording the final animation. Now, I'll add a ready-made scene from the resource library. I'll also enable the wind tool to make my animation look more dynamic and appealing. I start the simulation and animation recording. During the process, I notice that the hand gets stuck in the fabric. This is easily fixed by playing back and assisting the fabric in not following the hand, pulling it by it. Take a look at what I've achieved in the end. I'm satisfied with the result, so I'll proceed to render the images. Thank you. I choose an appropriate pose and initiate offline rendering. Sync is a preview, while final is the rendering of the final image. In the rendering settings, you can fine-tune more exclusive parameters and switch to GPU, if available. Adjust the aspect ratio and camera position as needed. Take a look at my final images. Now, I want to record an animation using real-time rendering. I'll replace the scene, change the placement of objects, and also create a new curtain made of fabric that will sway in the wind, just like the clothing. I'm selecting the fabric and adjusting the settings. The curtain will be in the background, so I won't make it too complex and detailed images. So everything is ready for me. Now, I'll play with the real-time rendering settings and adjust the real-time lighting. By rotating the lighting, I'm adjusting the position of the shadows from the objects. I thought that the frame on the left looks quite dull, so I decided to add a shadow from the tree. Thank you. I'm running the simulation with the wind again and recording the final animation. Take a look at what I've achieved. By the way, don't forget to save your project periodically at important stages. Sometimes, the computer load can be too high, and Style3D may shut down. I want to add camera tracking. I can choose one of the preset options, but they don't fit my animation. So, I'll set up the camera animation keys myself. By the way, the camera is simply the view of your 3D window in the program. After setting everything up and ensuring I like it, I move on to the export settings for my animation. I won't use offline rendering. Instead, I'll save the video directly from the 3D window of the program. Of course, I'll do this after configuring the real-time rendering settings. The export took only a few minutes, and the result is more than satisfactory. What do you think? Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.